Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for tuning in to tonight's dual meet with Loras College taking on the Central Dutch. I'm honored tonight to have my co-host and partner in crime is Jimmy Davis, former All-American for the Duhawks. Jimmy, welcome.
Thank you. Good to be here. Good
night. Fortunately, Worm was feeling a little bit under the weather, so you know what? I brought a next best thing. So tonight we're going to talk about wrestling instead of work, okay? Does that sound good?
Better than work, that's for sure.
All right, so a little bit of a recap of what's been going on lately, folks. Unfortunately, we weren't able to take our trip, Jim, down to Louisville and test our skills due to COVID, and that's kind of sweeping through right now. So we're hoping for the kids to get healthy all across so we can stop that kind of nonsense. So the guys are ready definitely tonight to get some wrestling action going, as it's been a long layoff since Nashville, where we dominated. So the Central Dutch come in ranked number 12 in the country, and they're going to have some formidable opponents. I did notice that a couple of their guys, their key guys, aren't in the lineup tonight. For what reason, I'm not 100% sure, but you know what? We're going to wrestle whoever they put out in front of us and give the crowd and the folks at home a good show. So from a lineup standpoint tonight, Loras is going to be sending out Jared Hensley, Aiden Evans, Jalen Schropp, Daniel Meeker, Zeke Smith, Gabe Pfizer, Jacob Krakow, Shane Legal, Colin Murphy, and Brady Vogel. Sorry. And for the Dutch, we'll update you as they are coming through. So starting out at 125 pounds, as I was saying, for your Duhawks, number 12 ranked, Jared Hensley is going to be taking on Carlos Pozos from Madera, California. Looking to get out to a fast start here, Jim. All right, double unders right away for Jared Hensley. Good sprawl. See if he can score here in short offense. Nice snap down. We'll throw by. Let's see if he can. Watch the headlock now. Good two-point takedown, Jim. Hensley likes to likes that look sit-back ride there, where he's looking to get some two back counts quite a bit, but he likes to get off to a fast start, that's for sure.
Good breakdown. Important to get some riding time right off the bat.
2 minutes and 20 seconds left to go in the first. He's already got 20 seconds of riding time. Deep half. Really deep half, nice. Jim. What's he got to do here to get this? Get the fall?
He's got to bring that forearm inside his chest. There it is.
Sit back. Sit back. Sit back.
That'll push him.
Hensley. He's going right back to it, it looks like, Jimmy.
That puts us in a really good spot for the rest of the match.
Already coming up on 50 seconds of riding time here. Yeah, this he's in trouble again.
He's got to get that forearm into his chest.
Ooh, settle back. Oh, escape. Pozos. All right, let's get another takedown here. A minute and 38 seconds. Let's get back to that snap action. That was a really good snap down that he had for the first takedown. Finish here.
Needs to bring that up in the air and keep his hands locked on the leg.
Like I said, there's a layoff here, so it'll be interesting to see if we got any rust at all, but ooh, Hensley does not look rusty. That looked like two. Van Tiger, there it is. Yep.
Hensley.
And off the mat. 102 left to go here in the first.
With a minute left, really important we finish on top here.
Pozos right up to his feet here, looking for an escape.
Nice.
We did creep over a minute in over a minute of riding time here. So just the first period, 8-2 lead for Jared Hensley. A Good job stopping here. He's got him.
Need to get his hips back. Hips back here.
Oh, now he's got a bar possibly. Got a deep waist here with that left arm trapped. 28 seconds left to go. 10-2 lead for Jared. Watch for the sit back. All right. Here's that ride out I think that you were asking for, Jim.
Yep, 15 seconds left, up by 8. Oh, nice. We'll finish period out here.
All right, so Central seems to content to stay in that position right now as we're going to go into the second period. Looks like Central's decision here in the first match of the night, 125 pounds. So 10-2 lead, minute and 39 seconds of riding time. This is interesting. He takes neutral. He had a couple shots on us, but we were able to stop him for a go behind. Oh, nice shot.
Take down, Hensley.
Looked pretty easy out there, huh, now? Roll through, be careful. Oh, he's got that deep
arm
again. So you're looking to grab that far wrist and pull it into your chest?
Yeah.
All right.
The thing about these small guys, it's so flexible, it's hard to get some turns here with how squirrely some of these guys can be, as light as they are.
All right, he's working forward. Warning, stalling on bottom man. There could be another stall call here pretty soon
there
if he doesn't
be
get
really quick. He's got to get off his stomach.
Jim, you as a guy who liked to work on top quite a bit, you would almost kind of let the guys up so you could go to your tilt actions quite a bit and pulling it in. We'll see some more of that a little bit later and some of the guys that like to tilt a little bit more, but Jared just likes to work wrists. And
Jared's put this guy in a really tough spot in this position this time of the match. As the type of lead we got, this guy really doesn't have time to waste on bottom here.
Uh-oh, that's trouble. Oh, come on, couple fall. It's going to be another four for sure, and there it is.
Looks like he's going to get it here.
There it is. Yes, fall for good. Jared Hensley.
That's a good way to start this duel.
Absolutely. 6-0 lead with the fall. That's a good match. Good match back. Like I said, it's been a couple weeks since the guys have competed. And, yeah, he looked good.
He did look good. That's a good start for us here. Important duel.
All right. Right into the 133-pound match. So we got Chase Poston from Olympia, Washington. He's going to be taking on our very own Aiden Evans from Bettendorf. Evans has been on an absolute tear, dating all the way back. He suffered a tough loss against a good opponent up in Wisconsin, and since then he's been on an absolute tear, and just literally and figuratively I've been watching him try to tear guys' arms off. So he's been good to watch. We'll see how the layoffs affect him. But
just a sophomore too, so we got a lot of time to see him develop.
Absolutely. Came out of high school with a pretty nasty knee injury, and he's rehabbed that all the way through. Had a good freshman year for what it was worth, with the limited competitions they had last year. But he's really started to put it together, up a weight from last year too. I think he fills the position pretty well for 133, so he's fun to watch. So all right, not much action here. Almost a minute into this third period. Like I said, I think the Dutch, they were down maybe in Florida or something competing the week after we were, week and a half after we were in Nashville. So they have wrestled recently, and we've only been wrestling each other, so you guys got to be hungry. All right, hopefully everybody out there is staying warm where you're at. Enjoying some wrestling tonight.
Need to get some head position here, control the center.
Central's backing up.
Oh.
Crowd wants stalling. Nice shot by Aiden. Shot. Upside down. What's he got to do here, Jim, to get this finish?
He's got to get in between the legs. On one side. There he is. Got it. Now he just needs to take his time. Nice and slow. He's got the takedown pretty much here locked in. Oh, he needs to keep his feet away.
Crowd's calling for two. Nothing yet?
Nothing yet. He needs to get his arms off his leg.
Cross face here or what?
Yep. Yep. He's got to be careful, though. If he pressures too far forward, he might get rolled through and end up in a stalemate.
I like him to get backs here. Let's see what happens.
Oh, he's got to get his foot free.
Oh, he's got it locked up, Jimmy. He's got it locked up.
Needs to keep one foot in.
He's got it
We're
in.
Getting backs. We're getting backs. Should be four here.
I can't see what Mike has for.
He's still got the cradle locked up, so we can't get any two here. Should be four.
Four backs. Oh, that was a really savvy move on the edge of the mat there to be able to lock that cradle up and keep that foot in bounds and not roll out.
It was.
So 30
seconds left. We should finish period out on top.
Oh, yeah, this guy can ride. Oh, good start here. Yes. He wants to go right to that shin toss. His head's right on the mat. That's good. That's where we want him to be. Watch this here. He likes this wrist ride on this side. Watch this, Jim. It's a little bit unconventional. I haven't seen a whole lot of kids come through and ride like this, but it's pretty effective for him, and I've seen him pin a heck of a lot of guys out of this. But his opponent's doing a good job keeping his hips up right now, not allowing him to do much.
Really good start here. Good first period from Evans.
Nice job, Aiden. 44 seconds of riding time here. Second period, it's our choice. He's going to go down. Very good start. So right here, what we want him to create action right off the whistle. No hanging around. So
caution red.
So students, I believe, other than J-term, I think students are out right now. So not a ton of students here tonight, but obviously our wrestling team is here, and they're loud. So it's good to have. Said the referee, Mr. Van Tiger, tonight. He's been around doing this quite a long time, even since I was wrestling. All right, hip separation, huh? He's almost out here. Headhunt.
Take his time here.
Good job by the central wrestler to feel the danger. 7-0. Yeah, he felt that. He had to bail. Otherwise, it was going to be some trouble.
One, not two is common saying. Back into the same position here.
Last time he sat on his butt.
Really what he needs to be focused on is keeping his feet free. It's hard to score when you can't move your feet.
Okay, what about now, though? This looks pretty good. Oh, same as what you're saying now. Central's got an opportunity. His head's higher. Look at this. It's a funky
position.
This might
get called into potentially dangerous here pretty soon.
Watch his back. There you go. All right. Put ourselves in a kind of a funky position there, but we were able to get the stalemate. So 7-0 lead, 53 seconds left to go here in the second period. Takedown on a ride out or takedown on some backs. I never just say, like, just hang out, right?
That's
you're always looking for points.
Right,
that was a hell of a shot. We're never wanting to just kind of hang out for a period. We want to score as much as possible. Crowd's wanting stalling.
The only position that's worse than being on your back is being on your stomach, and Central has spent a lot of time there here at 133.
Yep, head on the mat, but Lutch out now. Step over. See what he's doing here, hitting the Granby?
Oh, yeah.
But
he's got the right arm trapped in a figure four here. It's pretty.
8 seconds.
Can't do that with the head. He might get called.
Got to hang on. 4 seconds. Nothing yet.
He's got that foot.
No, he doesn't give him one. Yeah, I was going to say, I was wondering if he's going to give him one. He did give him the escape there, which is warranted. So we end the second period at a minute and 7 seconds of riding time here. Now we got to really dig deep. This is what I'm saying. Aiden's been in a lot of quick matches of late. Then we've been on that. We had the layoff with no competition. So what can we do right now? What can we do right now here in the third period to extend the lead, keep the major, or look for the tech fall? That's what we want to do. We want to extend our leads in the third period. No hanging out. So I think he's got it in him for sure. As I was saying before,
up by 8 right now, 1:07 riding time, so pretty crucial here. We don't give up a takedown. We don't have very much time to spare for the riding time. Need to be scoring.
Nice shot by the central wrestler. Low single.
Good scramble here.
He's got us in a bad way. We got to be careful.
He's got a leg cradle here. Looking like he's going for a stalemate. Might get called here pretty soon. Oh, nope. Not a good spot to be in for Evans.
All right, good. Belly out. All right, now we're going to lose it. We're losing our riding time here.
We're down or up by 6. We need to get going here to get some bonus points out of this match. Looks like Central's going to be going for the win, cutting them here, trying to get some more points on the board.
Don't be messing around in that.
He needs to get going. We need bonus points here.
All right. Come on, Aiden. So 10-3 here. 36 seconds left to go.
Got 30 seconds to get a takedown, secure the major. Heading the hole. He needs to get his chest up here, not a whole lot of time.
All right, I got 22 seconds here. Takedown or ride out for the major. Let's go, Aiden.
Up by 7, 22 seconds left. No riding time. Riding time's not a factor.
Central seems a little bit content here. He's got to go for a throw at this point. 9 seconds.
Nice. Good job.
The central bench can't really understand why he did that, why he went for that throw, because then it gave up a major. They're not really sure. You see there, a couple-time All-American, Daniel Page, who's assistant coach, is kind of like, what's going on? Why would we do that?
Yeah, so, not a smart move with 7 seconds left, down by 7.
Coach Van Clay's too. He's kind of giving it to his wrestler, you know, like, you know, that's – because in tight dual meets, you know, that those points matter so much. But you know what? We'll take it. You know what I mean? So good for the Duhawks. Glad to see Aiden back out.
You know, more times than not with top 10 ranked teams, the duels come down to 2, 3, 4 points. That can be, you know, that could be 1 or 2 bonus point matches, and that was one of them right there.
100%. Right here we got Brock Beck from Grinnell, Iowa. He's going to be taking on Loris Duhawk. Jalen Schrupp.
Schrupp's another young kid who's looked really, really good in his career so far.
Yep. State champ out of Williamsburg, Iowa. Kind of like it a little bit more when we're wrestling on Friday nights, because then we get a lot more audience and we get a lot more people in the stands. Thursday night we're competing with Iowa wrestling, high school wrestling, and there is no competing with that. So
yeah. There is free admission for youths, and Thursday nights there's a lot of high school duels that clubs and high school kids go to that we miss out on. But
all right, so Jalen's got he's got to work here, as Beck's got him in a position we don't want to be in for sure. He's kind of just holding tight. He looks comfortable.
Yeah, Jalen looks pretty comfortable here. Looks like this might end up in a stalemate. Getting some separation, yeah.
See, I would like to say that watching, you know, Schrupp again, he was a freshman last year, he All-American for us in the NWCA, and he had a good tournament and a good showing towards the end of the year. I think if you were to talk to him, he would probably tell you that his worst position is probably wrestling on his feet. So when he scores takedowns, his winning percentage is through the roof. So it's just sometimes comes out a little flat-footed. But those are things that he's been working on and training on hard, you know. That's the next level for him is this first period, because he's a heck of a mat wrestler. And that's not to say, Jim, that he doesn't have good stuff on his feet. I'm just saying that's the one position.
Oh, yeah.
And he's young, just like Evans. He's only, you know, technically a freshman. If you, you know, you don't count last year or however it works. Okay, a minute to go here in the first, no score.
He's also one of these MAC guys, first period going into second period, 0-0 is not a huge deal when you're comfortable on the mat.
It's going to be Central Choice. We'll be interested to see what they choose. But then again, you know, they've only fired off one shot as well, so.
Central Choice going into second period, 0-0, more than likely to defer.
All right, with that major decision, the Duhawks do lead the dual meet after two matches, 10-0. All right, 10 seconds left, Jim, in the first. Nice little throw-by attempt there for... Elbow to the shot, so... They did defer.
Birdaz will take down. Get on the board first, hopefully.
Yep, create some action here. Create some action.
Give up as little riding time as possible here.
They got Beck listed
right
as a sophomore.
Right to his feet. Clock's on Central. He's got to get working here on her feet. He might get hit here pretty soon. He'll have about 5 seconds. There we go.
Oh, he let him go. He knew it was one or the other.
Yeah.
And the worst thing that happens is you let him go, and then you get it and then let him go.
Well, it's such a bad position. You give up stalling points because it comes back to bite you when it gets really tight towards the end.
Sure can. All right, Jalen, get moving here. So 1-0 here with a minute and 20 seconds left to go here in the first, or sorry, the second. Good movement. Got to see some more of that. I can hear the Central bench telling their wrestler that he needs to create action. It's very well true. I mean, somebody needs to create some action here. Could be tough for Beck to shoot through that underhook unless he's trying to look for maybe like a carry or something. All right, see, this is where right now this is where Jalen needs to get confidence. He's got a single, he's got a double. Like, fire off. Here he goes to one.
Real important in these positions, keep your feet free when he tries to turn in. In a good spot here.
Plenty of time, 26 seconds.
Yep.
All right, there we go.
Clear that foot.
Snag it. Okay.
Yep.
Now we got 16 seconds. It'll be interesting now. Jim, what do you think? I mean, if it goes 1-0,
against guys really good on top, you know, going into the third period, going down with it 1-0 puts you in a tough spot for Central.
Well, especially since neither wrestler's been hit for stalling.
Nope.
I mean, neither wrestler's really done too much yet as far as offensive moves go. I mean, they're both kind of hanging out. And I think they both have offense, but they're just not really letting it go. There's a nice movement here with 4 seconds left to go in the second.
More than likely, Central's going to choose bottom here. We'll see what
Coach Van Clay. Right away, neutral.
Yep.
Neutral. Yep. He looked right at him, and he's like, no, not going down.
That's probably a good choice. Probably a good choice.
Get ready, Jalen. You get ready on the whistle now. Come on. Move your feet. All right. So, takedown. Takedown pretty much, I think, can seal the deal for us. So we need to get on our offense, get moving our feet here. Come on, kiddo. Said you start getting in a little bit into deeper waters here. You can see where the layoff is, I think, kind of showing through, if you ask me. Nice shot by Central.
Dive through the ankles here. This is going to be a tough spot to score from Central. Might end up in a stalemate here. Potentially dangerous might be.
Watch his back. Yeah, it's going to be tough. Okay, hold on. Now we got our knees under us here a little bit. We're slipping out. He's slipping out.
Yeah, yeah. Tough spot.
That was a long time. I thought the stalemate was going to come a little bit sooner, but to no avail. All right, come on, kiddo. Move your feet here. 1 minute to go here, Jim, in the third. 1-0 lead for us. Nice shot. Look at he's looking
we're
to stack him up.
Here.
Wow, he bailed on that, Jim.
That's okay.
No, that's great for us. I was surprised to see it. I don't know if the injury looks like he's got his kind of shoulder banged up a little bit. I don't know what happened there, but he bailed, kind of gave it up.
Well, he had that arm trapped. He was worried maybe about giving up exposure there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Jalen went right to like what he looked like was going to be like a tilt.
A tough ride here. Good, that's good position. That's a good, great job there.
They're going to keep him down. They're going to keep him down.
Stayed on his leg there. That's great. That's good wrestling. Real smart situational play there.
All right, it's time to get tough. We need to ride this guy out. This is what big matches are all about. This is what we're going to need later on in the season, the next couple weeks as we get into tournament season and postseason action. All right, so 3-0, 28 seconds left to go.
TJ's motion to Jalen keep him down here. I think that's the plan.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, this is, you know,
there's
this
no
is
no reason to let him get away here.
There's an opponent that you're going to be wrestling at the regional tournament. You know, we got a. This could be, you know, a match. Conti semis if it had to
there
be something
is,
like
back
that.
To his stomach, probably the worst
quarterfinals.
Place he could be right now on his stomach with 10 seconds left.
That's where we wanted to be. We're going to secure the win here. Good showing for Jalen back. Like I said. Tough kid.
That's
tough to score on.
Good solid match there. Smart wrestling.
Yep. Created enough action to get the takedown when he needed to. That's going to bring the dual meet score to 13-0 after the 141 bout. All right, tonight now at 149, we're going to see Daniel Meeker coming in. Ruiz might be getting the night off. I see him in the crowd. So, looks like Daniel's going to come out here. I love watching this kid wrestle. He's a fireball, man. Like, the guy's got a gas tank on him. So, Daniel listed as a sophomore from Oakville, Iowa. Wrestled at Wapello.
Oh, good shot. Would like to see him stay on the leg there. Good wrestling.
Yeah. Looks like for Central, Duncan Dazell from Burlington, Iowa, Burlington High School. Meeker
taking,
double unders.
Taking a few long shots here so far in the beginning. We want to see him set those up a little bit more.
These guys are both listed as sophomores, so I'm not sure if they, being from southeastern Iowa a little bit, I don't know if they ran into each other much or not in high school. So 1 minute through the first period in the 149-pound bout.
Oh, might be in possibly good position here. That's
a two-point takedown for Central, but I like where we're at here.
We are in a good spot.
Pop the head.
To step around, get his far leg in. Looks like he did.
That's got
to
be two right there.
It's going to be pretty close. Soon as
where's the reversal, Mike?
Head,
there it is. Now let's go to work. Good. Okay, quick escape for Central. There we go. Now we got some points, 3-2. So it was a little slide by there for Central. All right, about a minute left to go here. Again, I'd like to thank everybody who's tuning in tonight and glad you're able to join us for this edition of Loras College Wrestling. This weekend, we look to hit the mats at the Mattman Invitational down at Cornell College in Mount Vernon, Iowa. I think with the layoff and whatnot, I believe Coach Miller is planning on taking quite a big group down there since we weren't able to go to Louisville. So that'll be good. Some really good tournament action down there in Cornell. Then the following week, we have our ARC duels in Cedar Rapids, which is presented with Coe and Luther and Simpson and Nebraska Wesleyan. So two straight tough weekends of wrestling here for the Duhawks coming up. And those are so important because the regional seedings are huge, and every one of those matches at conference duels are massive. All right, it's going to be our choice. We're going down. We are losing right now 3-2. I believe this is the first match that we actually have a deficit in. Central has 6 seconds of riding time, so it's not relevant now, but we need Meeker to create some action here, Jimmy.
Got right to his feet here. Good job.
Good cutaway. Good cutaway. Let's get on your offense here. Come on, move your feet. Nice shot there.
Good transition to a single there. Good. Very good wrestling.
Still nothing. Wow, these guys are moving.
Reattack. Nice. Good. Wow. Wow. Yeah, it was a quick, potentially dangerous.
Probably, that was trouble.
Probably a good call for a ref to protect the wrestlers. But what a very good exchange there for Meeker.
Yeah, you don't want to let that go too far. It's one of them things. It looks like he was pretty comfortable in that position, but how are you supposed to know if you're the ref, right?
Well, so number one job is wrestler safety. So.
Yep. All right, so really good exchanges right here, right out the gate in the third period. We need a takedown, I believe, though, in this period because, you know, Central's going to have their choice. So,
want to see Meeker get a little bit more busy with his hands and motion
yes.
here. Every time he's gotten to a leg, he's put himself in a really good spot to score. And
there it is again.
He just needs to get back to his fighting here.
Again, the same position.
And he's
– jeez. These guys are out there freestyling, it looks like.
He's got a lot of good action, but I just want to see him getting busy with his hands. I mean, he's having no trouble getting to his legs.
Right. You're saying a better setup's going to eat. There it is. A better setup's going to be have a better result, right?
Well, see, he's not moving very much with his hands. You know, he's standing far away from him, and not much hand fighting going on in this match. A lot of just diving like he did right there, which has been getting in on the legs pretty easy this whole match so far.
Well, the highest paced match we've got so far. 16 seconds left to go here in the second. Like I said, Central's choice, so I see no reason why he's not going down in the third. A nice zero answer would be good. No shot, though. There, see that movement right there at the end of the period is what we need in the middle of the period. Get to the double. See what they're doing. He's going down. All right, another third period here, back-to-back matches.
We're going to need a turn or a takedown from Meeker at some point in these next 2 minutes.
I think there's a lot of action coming out of this match here. Let's keep moving.
Oh, yeah, far from over.
That's look like a Central jumped. Did it not? I don't know. It's kind of weird, but.
Well, either way, it's where we want to be, get a takedown. We got more time.
Yeah, but might need two. Let's go here, Dan. Moving. Move your feet. There it is. A little bit better. Let's see if we can open up the gas tank that I alluded to earlier.
There we go. He needs to stay on him with his hands, just like that snap. And he needs a little bit more action with his hands. We don't have a lot of time to waste. 5:20 left.
Yeah, we can't wait until 30 seconds. Come on.
Needs to get busy with his hands.
Nice shot.
Back in on
there
the leg.
Is. There it is. Come on,
hop
up. That's
a very good takedown.
Now he's got him in trouble here too, Jimmy.
On his stomach.
He's
on
his belly. Get to it. Oh, watch out now.
Nah.
We don't need to mess around there.
He hasn't been called yet. One wouldn't be the end of things.
I know.
He's got one hand on the mat, so he can't get hit for stalling here.
This is a strange match.
He's got one hand on the mat, so the referee motioning. Now we're at the edge of the mat. He needs to be smart.
Now
here.
He's stalled. Now
that's
he's
okay.
Stalling.
It's okay. He's back down. We have one to waste. We got 40 seconds left. We have one waste.
You have to understand the difference, though, here. This kid gets up to his feet.
Yep.
You got to cut him. Because what you can't do is give up the second stall call
right.
and then give up the escape.
Right. Now the second time, but we had one to get warned on. That was a good position to do at the edge of the mat.
Mm-hmm. Get forward pressure. Oh, right up to it.
That's not what we want here.
Maker's in trouble, too, because that's a cradle and backs.
Yeah.
No backs yet.
No backs
yet. So we can
yet.
Still get out here. Fight it off. There's two. We're in trouble now.
Nah, he did give up backs. Oh, man, that's a tough one. He was in a good position majority of the match here, just the very end.
All right, 10 seconds left. Let's go. Come on, bud. All right, looks like it's going to be a win here for the Central wrestler, Duncan Dizell. That's a pretty good match for those two.
That was a very good match for Meeker. I wouldn't be disappointed with that one at all. It was just one minor mistake at the very last 10 seconds it cost him.
Yep, very young still, like I said. More action here in the lineup in the future, and he'll be able to, here's what I tell you is that... You know, I'm not sure if that's the guy at 149 for them. I think they got a wrestler from, an older guy from California, I think, who's in that spot right now. I don't see him here tonight. He didn't weigh in. But point is, so it's a good exposure for him. It's a good chance to get a dual meet in front of the crowd. But, you know, small things like that you got to build on. So he will, too. So, all right, 157 pounds. Our very own Zeke Smith is going to be taking on Luke Condi. Condi's from Memphis, Tennessee, Christian Brothers Academy, and Zeke Smith from Prairie du Sauk, Wisconsin. Zeke's all the way up at 157, wrestled at 125 as a freshman. Hard to freaking believe. I mean, he's filled in for the 57-pound class quite well, so. Oh, a little throw by attempt here for Condi. We're in a little trouble. No back points. Oh, kind of just got Zeke extended a little bit there, huh? A
little bit. Coming off first minute, looks like he wasn't totally ready to go right off the bat. But good thing about Zeke is he can put points on the board pretty quick, so it's not a huge deficit.
Nice shot by Smith.
And
handles on the mat there, didn't give it to him.
Here we are. Ooh.
Take down, Smith.
Know where you're at.
That's not a time to give one away here. He needs to step out before he gives up that stall call. Little bit more situational awareness there from Zeke. But here we are right back in the lead.
All right, so that is a stall call against Zeke Smith for holding the leg. You got the full count there. The scoreboard, okay, it's 3-2. All right, they got it right now. All right, minute and 40 seconds. Okay, caution on Central. Minute and 46 seconds left to go here in the first, so see if Zeke can get a breakdown and go to work on top.
Zeke's very tough on top here. He got to his position right away. On his stomach, Zeke's going to go to work here. This is a very tough spot to be in against Zeke.
Yeah, the Smiths are known for their pounding when, effort on top. I mean,
when Zeke gets two legs in like that, it's really tough. I don't care what weight you are, it's tough.
Yep, Zeke comes from a long line of wrestlers from the Buick community, the Smith brothers, who are his uncles and his dad, obviously his brother was not all American for us. His sister is a heck of an athlete for us here at Loras, so.
Got that far wrist.
I mean, for the bottom guy here, you're kind of like, what can I do?
The way things are going, I mean, he's going to get hit for stalling here pretty soon.
Coach Van Clay's in the corner, in the corner, trying to express concern because his guy's on the bottom, but and on his belly, and he's wanting, you know, he's like, what are we doing? Get us a stalemate. He's wanting that call, but nothing yet.
He's going to get hit for stalling before we get hit by a stalemate. That's for sure.
All right, 30 seconds left to go here in the first. We're up to a minute. We're up over a minute of ride time. You can hear the crowd wanting the stall call.
Not much you can do on bottom.
There's
a
stall call.
Yep. Yep. Both wrestlers have been worn in the first period.
Did they go a stalemate here? We got blood, or what is it?
Looks like blood. So.
All right. During this blood time here, and like I said, Jim, score now is 13-3 since the Dutch did get that victory at 149 pounds. So, got to get back on the winning train and the bonus train here. So, yeah, the crowd actually did turn out, like I said, considering that high school wrestling is going on. It's senior versus Hempstead over at senior tonight.
Yep.
So we actually did end up with quite a few. A lot of parents, so it's nice to see them traveling as much as they can. So, all right, so here we go. We got 7 seconds here in the first period. Central up to his feet. Zeke with the mat return. Nice. That'll end the period.
Right back to where he wants to fight. He can get in that position so quick, and it's really, really tough to fight out.
That was a great mat return there.
He's
going to defer. We're going down. Let's go.
Zeke's going to go down. Hopefully build to his lead here pretty quick.
All right. So, Jimmy, we ended with 1:42 of riding time after that first period. So
and Zeke is right to his feet. He's out in under 10 seconds. Really
so,
good.
So I saw when there was the blood timeout, Coach Miller was talking to him, and he was saying, stop getting extended on your high crotch shots, because that's what happened in that first high crotch. He took that shot, and the kid hit the whip over. So he said to him, okay, head in the hole a little bit. This is where the Smiths live, right here, the head in the hole. This is going to be tough. Connie's doing a good job of being able to actually keep that one shoulder, but we'll see if he's able to straighten it out. I think we might get a stalemate here.
We might. He's gripping his shoulder blade with his right arm. It's really hard to
There it is.
Move.
Yeah. So a lot of times guys will fall back down. You're able to get that head in the hole. And like I said, that's almost like a I know that was an Eddie Smith signature head in the hole action right to the double boots. So all right, we got a 4-2 lead. 1:10 left to go here in the second. Zeke's working the head pretty good. He's moving better now than he was in the first even. Nice snap. It snaps him into his leg. What's he got to do here, Jim?
He needs to get one of these close legs up in the air. Otherwise, we're going to end up in a stalemate. Yep, he's reaching for it. He gave up on it.
So sometimes you'll see guys either pull that in or hook that and try to even get cradles out of that position a little bit once in a while.
When he's got his leg under his head like that, he's going to want to try to lift it into the air. Otherwise, like I said, what we saw, we end up in a stalemate.
Oh, nice shot. Get the 2-on-1.
Really good shot. Not extended.
All right, we got 24 seconds left to go. Head underneath. Okay, now we're looking at danger rule. 1, 2.
When he turns away, Zeke's going to end up with a turd.
Oh, boy. Yes. Yes. Nice move. Nice job, Zeke Smith. That's one of them situations.
Going to finish out the period on his stomach. Not a good spot.
Condi doesn't have a whole lot he can do there. He's given up either the danger, and then you can start giving up back points.
Right.
You know, I mean, he really had no choice but to bail, but Zeke came right back across with that mean crossface. So good for him. Right to neutral for Central. So here it is. 1:50 of riding time. We're up 6-2. Looking to build our lead here. Looking for the major. Good movement. So he wants to be double unders, but we definitely want to control with our left arm. We want to have our underhook there. That's where Zeke wants to be. Central's coming forward. Nice, banging in there. These guys are going after it in this match, I can tell you that. Another shot.
This kind of hand fight now I would like to see from Meeker. If he had the kind of hand motion that Zeke has right now, that match 149 would have been a completely different story.
I think so, too, because there's less rolling around. You know, you start beating on somebody's head.
The thing about Meeker is he had no problem getting into his legs. It was just getting past his hands.
Yep.
That was the issue.
All right, so we're back in that position we were in last period, but Zeke's
now he's got
it. So there is the difference that you were talking about.
Push that arm down off his shoulder blade, and we're right back into our
So we got a six-point lead.
Our legs.
We got a seven-point lead. Riding time's locked, all right? So right. We need a turn, or we need another takedown, or we need a stall call. So you can.
I wouldn't be surprised here if we get to 30 seconds. Zeke cuts and tries to get the major here.
I don't know here. I think Coach Miller wants a stall call. But crowd's calling for it a little bit. But, yeah, you see he's getting his legs out here. You might be right. Oh, no, he's going back in with him, Jim. All right, 39 seconds.
I wouldn't be surprised if we didn't get this call. He might get hit here on his stomach, not moving.
Okay, whoa. Forward with it. Man, he's cranking that. That's got to be.
Yeah, at this point, we need to.
This is trouble. This is trouble for Central. This is trouble for Central. Come on. You got to go back at the shoulder. Yes. Nothing, Jim.
Nope.
Well, that's trouble. That was trouble. I can't believe he fought that off. Good for the Central wrestler. Somehow didn't give up backs. There it is.
No.
Okay.
That was a good try for Zeke.
Yeah, it was. That was a great match. I know we didn't end up with the major there, but definitely the second and third period, he really started to separate himself. And you know what? Give credit where credit is due there end where the Central wrestlers doesn't give up those back points.
Well, and Zeke really wasn't in a position to cut him. He had that power half. It looked like we were going to get back points there for a little bit, so not much more Zeke could have done there.
Right. I'm not sure which wrestler they sent out. So I'm not exactly sure which guy we have here for Central. They had two listed, Chris Wilson or Colby Tool. So, and then for us, obviously, wrestling is Gabe Beiser. Good to see Gabe back. Gabe from Grundy, Virginia. Nice shot by Central.
He got his legs back right away.
Yeah, that was a good action there for both guys.
Oh, wow.
Good circle. Now we score here on the edge.
See, that's
Ooh,
a tough
could,
spot
that's
to
the
beat.
Stalling that, now that, for that, that guy.
That could very, yep, yep, we got it.
That's trouble. You're right, because now we have the underhook, and all of our action is taking us out.
Yep.
You know, if you're that guy. So good for us there. Early stall call, right call. Let's get to the heavy hands here. Gabe's got some heavy hands. He likes to hand fight.
See, a stall call early for Gabe could be huge. A lot of his matches are usually, you know, 3-2, 4-2, 5-3 type matches for Gabe.
All right, now he's got the underhook. Now he went to the other
good
side.
Good re-attack.
So he went left side, right side. Central's able to get his hips back, though.
We need to get moving here. Not a good spot to be wasting energy.
Create an angle here one way or another, or what?
Oh, yeah, back to his feet, head up into his chest. Now we're in a spot to
nice
score.
Dump.
Yep.
Nice dump. And we got him trapped here on the other side, on the left side.
Yep. Good, solid, tight waist. We're going to burn some time off the clock here for sure.
That is great job getting the offense. Cradle locked.
Yeah, cradle locked. Near side cradle. It's a good one to get some points on.
Want to be smart here. There's a lot of time left in the period.
Lots of time. Yep.
Oh, he just kind of pulls him right over.
Wow. You know, he might get it here.
He's got to get that knee in the side, huh? So a little bit looks like the Central wrestler is a little bit the other way.
It's hard to see from our angle, but he could very well get it here. Looks like he got some separation. Nope.
He must not have felt it. He let it go.
Earball.
Wow.
Pfizer.
He's got the leg turked. We're going to burn a lot more time here with that.
Way to go, Gabe. This is looking off to a hell of a start here.
Yep.
Coming into, like I said, with this layoff, he looks great right off the bat. All right. Pressure forward with a little suck back, maybe. A little Sorensen, Mike. All right. Gives up the escape. 52 seconds left. Let's see where those heavy hands are at and get another score. Shorter offense. Yeah, that's border. That's another stall call. Man, I tell you what. He looks great tonight.
He did get a point there for fleeing the mat.
Point for Mike.
Also, what I really like out of Gabe is how well he can hand fight. His hands are really heavy. He's always moving. He's always creating action on his feet.
Yeah, he comes from a pretty good line. His dad wrestled for University of Iowa, you know, and I'm sure he was taught from a young age how to hand fight. But
yep,
just
nice. Very, very, very
clean. Oh, he
very clean there. Central. Looking at the clock, looking like he wanted to maybe let him up, try to get another one, but not enough time for that right now.
And I'll tell you, I mean, no matter the opponent, this is the best he's looked in a little while as far as his hand fighting and his moving his feet. I mean, he's looked great coming out here.
Gabe's most comfortable on his feet. I wouldn't be surprised here if he kept it going on his feet.
All right, so second period, guys. It's a 9-1 lead. We've already got 1 minute and 9 seconds of riding time.
Yep. Yep.
Let's him out, just like you thought, Jim.
He's not having any trouble getting to his takedowns. So.
No, and like you said before, it's like we start creating the action with our hand fighting and heavy hands.
How heavy he is with his hands there.
You don't want to be in that. You don't want to be in this match very long if you're getting thrown around. So we'll see another snap here to a high crotch. Let's go.
He's gonna pull one off here. Oh. He's gonna have one more hard snap.
All right, minute and 15 seconds, 9-2 lead for the Duhawk over the Dutch.
Good.
Another
high
nice
crotch.
High crotch.
Very good high crotch. Got to bring that foot up into the air.
And not much fight right now out of Central here.
No, not very. Right to his stomach.
You know, and it's just one of them situations, you know, like where it's, you know, like sometimes the hand fighting gets to you early or you know what I mean, fought off a little bit here or there. And
yeah, wrestling 101. I mean, you're giving up a takedown, you're giving up points, so one thing you don't want to do is go to your belly.
All right, 39 seconds. We let him go again. So I see Coach Gloss is over in the corner, and he's telling him, you got to get another takedown, pick up the pace. If you're going to let the guy up, take him down.
Yep.
So minute and 30 seconds of riding time. Like I said, 24 seconds left to go in the period.
Oh, he should be scoring.
A little half shot here. I'd like to see a snap down.
Yep. Up in the air. Good job. See, right back to his stomach.
The corner wants to keep him down.
Yeah, 10 seconds left. That's what we need to do. It's pretty hard to cut and take down in 10 seconds.
All right, 13-3 going into the third.
Beiser picks neutral. Get right back to it. Not much defense here left from Central.
No. If he really jumped up to the half, he could probably put him over, I bet. Or even cradle from here. He's waiting for him to come up.
Oh, he did, yeah.
15-3.
Yeah, he could get called here if he hangs out for too long. He already got his two. I'm not sure if he realizes or not.
You see what the wrestler's mat on the hand then? That's why you're not getting the count. So.
Yeah.
All right, 15-4. Riding time's locked up. Or just about to be, excuse me. See if he can push himself here to get the tech fall. Another shot.
He needs his takedown. Inside shelf.
He's got the other leg. Run him over. Run him over, kid.
Pfizer.
You can tell Glossa right now is in the corner.
So,
oh,
that's okay. Now here we need one more takedown to secure the tech.
See, and that's why you really can't stop wrestling there because, you know, even though he hadn't shown much life to that point, he showed a little life there, and you can't get caught blindsided. But 17-5, takedown or ride out? You said, Jim, right?
Takedown ride out will give us the tech. Yeah.
All right, Gabe. Like I said, I would say. Probably through and through. Gabe's probably looked the best so far we've seen tonight out of all the guys.
Yeah, his hand fighting is very,
nice
very
shot.
Solid.
Dude, that started in the middle. That started in the middle of the mat,
yeah,
and he ran it all the way through over. That was nice.
Now I want to try to keep him in bounds here as best we can.
Oh, keep that foot. Be smart, though, too.
The ride out will give us a tech on criteria with the riding time.
Okay. 13-6 here, 13-6. Like I said, even though the score is what it is, these are the situations.
10 seconds. Wow, that's not.
The corner is mad. The coaching staff wants to know what's going on.
TJ jumped off his chair. That is not.
Here we go. He'll score. He's going to score here.
Oh, man.
He is not happy.
TJ jumped off his chair after he saw that.
You know what? That's between those two guys, but. Hell of a match for Gabe Fizer. He wrestled from the beginning to the end. I'm going to give him credit for that.
He did. He wrestled a great match. It was a great match.
I think, unfortunately, we don't get to see Jacob wrestle tonight. I think it's going to be a forfeit, I believe. Yeah. That's frustrating. So Jacob's going to get the win. That's too bad. Everybody loves to see that kid wrestle.
Yeah.
So, you know, we love all of our guys, obviously. We want to see them, each one of those guys compete when we come to these things. So, all right, here we go. 184 pounds.
Legal ranked number 2 in the country right now, looking really, really, really good as always.
Russ is like a lightweight at 184. So, yeah. We got Peyton Hamerick. Princeton, Illinois, 184 pounds. Like I said, Shane Legal ranked number 2 right now. You're defending national champ here right away, right off the bat. Looking for a snap down, go behind. From what I understand, I got some information passed to me today. Shane's got some visitors or some family and friends watching him from Florida. So I want to give those guys a shout out. And thank you for tuning in to tonight's broadcast. So takedown for Legal right away. And an escape. So, Shane, a 3-time state champion from Spring Green, Wisconsin. Like I said, he
head went in the hole. Just need to keep his feet free here, and he should have it. There we go.
Kind of left our ankle leg out there, huh?
Yeah,
a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, we're not in the best positions. We've seen ourselves in this position a couple times tonight in the different matches.
Yeah, yeah. The key to that head in the hole, single leg up in the air like that is keeping your bottom feet free. I mean, you haven't been doing that tonight.
That's all right. See him get back to the short offense, like I said.
Shane's another one, a lot like Krenko and Fizer. His hand fight, he's so busy with his hands, and he does it all match. It, when we get into the third period, it starts to really wear down on guys. And he has no trouble putting points on the board fast.
Yep.
Yep.
Snapped us into him there a little bit.
Right away.
That's easy work.
He's got a really deep tight with those long arms. He's going to get busy here for a while.
All right, minute and 20 seconds, guys, here in the first period. As riding time begins to mount. Looks like we do have the Turk on the right leg.
Shane's going for his bar. He scored a lot of points with his bar half over the past few years.
Yeah, oh, for sure. And, you know, it's funny because he gets it. It's almost like they just give it up so easily sometimes. And I think things that he works on, you know, with pinning guys, because he gets a lot of back points. But then, like, his biggest thing
there
that he's always works on, here you go, watch it.
See, he Turks the right leg, shifts all the weight on the guy's left arm, and gets that bar nice and deep now.
See if he can settle back here, Jim. Like I said, this is where he struggles just a little bit to get the falls. He gets the back points constantly, but we'll see if he can settle his hips right there at the head. Looks good. That looks real good. And there it is. There's the pin. Just like that. Just like we wrote it up, folks. Good play-by-play there on that bar. That's like next level commentating, Jim. All right, a pin for Shane Legal. Hopefully his fans in Florida were able to watch that and enjoy. All right, here we go. We got a California kid here, Colin Murphy. His first year in the starting lineup for us. Colin is a senior from San Diego, California. He's coached by one of my coaches, Coach Spiziel. Hopefully everybody's doing good out there, everybody watching in California tonight.
One thing about Colin is he has made major leaps and improvement over the past few years. And it's been fun watching him get better and better every year.
I can tell you the difference is it's the mentality. It's like he strives to be really good. And when he lost, he couldn't figure out why. But now he's using that passion for on the mat versus after the matches. Okay? So he absolutely has made great strides since last year. He's been fun to watch. Like I said, he comes from a great program out in California. All right, already quickly up to 30 seconds of riding time. He's taking on Gage Linehan from Newton, Iowa. All right, escape for Gage. Another shot.
Oh, a little extended on that one, but good job getting back to his feet. He's all over him.
Yep. All right, reset here. Get to where we want to be. All right, minute and 30 seconds left to go here in the first. A little hand fight, not. You know, we probably want to be getting more on our snaps here, getting a little off balance, getting back to our outside single. There we go. All right. Follow up with a shot there. All right. And 1 minute left here. Another shot by Murphy.
It stopped his left arm. Central stopped his left arm. Hard to get past that. He needs to get past his hands first.
All right, moving. 40 seconds left to go here in the first. 2-1 lead for Murphy. All right, 20 seconds left to go. Let's see if we can get a quick one here and finish up on top. I'll tell you what, these guys are they're banging in there a little bit, though, Jim. So we'll see where the conditioning comes here in the second and third period. Some heavy hands. All right, Central's choice is going down. Like I said, 2-1 lead here for Colin Murphy. 39 seconds of riding time. Looks like we might have a little blood or something. Yep, okay. All right. Like I said, a reminder, folks, we're wrestling this weekend, the Cornell Mattman Invitational in Mount Vernon, Iowa. Like I said, great competition there. And then followed up by the duels. Looking forward to that. So I'll tell you what, this next month, it's a real big grind here, Jim. It's a real big grind this next month. Wrestling our conference opponents and then we're wrestling in the best conference in the United States for Division III wrestling. There's no question about that. So, all right, 2-2. He gets up to his feet. 45 seconds left to go here. 45 seconds of riding time for Colin Murphy.
Single leg.
Nice shot. Oh, he's stuck between the... Can he keep the Turk, though? Oh, know where you're at. Nice shot by Murphy, just kind of following through and driving through. Another escape. Just went over the minute riding time mark, but we're going to need another takedown this period. I think he's going to get one for us. All right. Update on the score, 32-3 in favor of your Duhawks. He said the lone setback was at 149 pounds.
You know, but I'm really not disappointed with that 149-pound match at all. He wrestled good.
No, hopefully he'll be able to have another chance to run into that opponent again this year, and avenge that loss. So, but like I said, overall, the guys have looked have looked fairly good for the layoff they've had. I know they've been training hard, and you know, you have those couple weeks where you're just training with your training partners. You know, you want to get out there and get some live action going, but it's just not the same until you get out there and wrestle the match. So nice job by Murphy moving his feet. 35 seconds left to go here in the second period.
Would like to see him get back to a single leg here before this period's over.
We're pretty much the aggressor in this match, don't you think, Jim?
Oh, yeah. I don't think he's taking a shot yet.
A little snap here might go a long way. 19 seconds. There's a kind of a half shot attempt then for Linyon. Oh, and now that's a shot. Score here, short time. All right, he's out. It's our choice. What I can only assume that we're going to go down. Looks like we got another blood stoppage. Let's be good here. Colin Bill get his head on straight as he's taken down. So, Jimmy, we got a minute and 1 second riding time. We're not going to have riding time after he, more than likely, after this exchange. But, I mean, unless Colin hits the fastest stand-up of all time. But the point, what I'm trying to make is we need to get out quick, get a takedown. You know what I mean? Build our riding time and start making this a little bit more of a dominant win. All right, right off the whistle. Ooh, kind of going to our belly a little bit. We don't want to be there. Come on, Colin. Roll through. Comes up. All right. 5-3 lead now for Murph. Oh, nice shot.
That's a good single leg.
You got to finish it.
He's pretty high percentage once he gets there.
Okay, take your time. Hands in the face. Locks the hands in the face. Now he kind of went to the side.
They've kind of leaned away from that. Really.
Oh, get the back. Stay between those legs.
Good job.
Another takedown here. Extends our lead to 7-3. Escape for Central. 7-4. We got 55 seconds of riding time. Just about a minute left to go here in the third. You were right. You nailed it on the head. He was able to convert that single leg pretty easily. Now here's the opportunity now. Can we build our lead? Because he's got to come after us a little bit. When he takes a bad shot, what can we do? Or when he takes a shot. There,
right there.
Now, exactly what I'm saying. Now, what can we do here? These are the situations where we need to score and build our lead. 40 seconds left to go here in the third. Okay, kind of hanging on the head again.
Not yet.
Well, yep. We want to score. We want to score there. Now we take a shot. Get your hands on him.
If he can get to his single, he's pretty high percentage once he can get there with his hands locked.
I think if we score a takedown here, we're riding him out. But only 15 seconds left to go. There's a shot and like a reshot almost through. I didn't see him getting to that.
His bottom foot here. This might be where the clock runs out here.
Mm-hmm. Good match coming back for Murph here as the time's about to wind down. We're going to win this match 7-4. Workmanlike performance, to say the least.
Oh, yeah.
You know, never. I don't think the match was ever really in doubt. You know what I mean? So
no,
good match for Colin.
It was a good solid win.
Yep, absolutely. Another 3 points on the board, extending our lead to 35-3. All right, here we go. It's coming down to heavyweight. Brady Vogel's coming out for us tonight.
And to preface, it's 35-3 going into heavyweight. Cornell is, Central is 6-2, ranked number 12 in the country. So it's a pretty good showing so far.
Yep. And Brady Vogel hails from Kansas by way of Iowa Central as well. He's given up quite a bit of size tonight to Zook.
Vogel is a Greco-Roman All-American.
Yep.
So he's given up a little bit of weight here, but he is...
Don't count him out of the match.
I would never, ever do that with Brady. He's given up some size, but he's definitely got it.
So here, the key in this situation with him giving up the size is probably moving, huh? Got to move on bottom. Here it is. Come on, kiddo.
It's a good knee slide. He needs to do everything he can to stay off of his belly. That's a lot of weight on top.
Yep.
And a pretty good ride here from Central.
Zook here is another wrestler out of the state of Washington for Central. And like I was telling you pre-match, Jim, Coach Van Clay's got some West Coast ties, Montana State Northern, you know, type situation. That's why he's recruiting into California, Washington, Oregon, you know. Some of his, you know, which sometimes you don't see a lot, but it's good to be able to see some talent from other states, you know, on the West Coast that you don't maybe see all the time, like Washington. So, all right, like I said, this is the situation we don't want to be in. He's up at a minute and 10, but see if Brady can work up. I mean, we're kind of in a bad spot here. Come on, bud. All right.
Central's got a pretty good ride here on top, and Brady, from the looks of it, looks like he's given up a good size advantage. It's going to be tough to get out here.
Well, movement right now.
Yep.
All right, minute and 45 seconds left to go. Jimmy, it sounds like you're in a playroom. You can hear those little kids. There are quite a few little ones out here tonight enjoying the meet. All right, 40 seconds left to go. Zook's up over 2 minutes of ride time. Like I said, again, it's just a tough situation for us.
You're right, Brady needs to get moving here, but. You gotta imagine how tough this ride's gotta be. Yeah, we did get hit for stalling. Not a lot of movement down on bottom. Good ride.
Now we're up to our feet.
Right away.
Big one here. Big one.
Oh.
Jeez. Good attempt there at the end of the period.
Almost 3 minutes of riding time after the first. That's gonna play a role for the rest of the match here.
Big snaps. We're gonna create action because you gotta create angles here against a guy bigger than you. Can't shoot straight on, but he knows that. He's been around a while.
Also tough. Vogel does like his throws and his locks, and it is tough when the opponent is taller than you to get the right leverage for those types of moves.
You can hear Coach Van Clay saying control the hands and get inside position. They don't want to give up any sort of throw whatsoever here.
That's the thing. He does have a lot of that in his arsenal, Brady.
All right, 1 minute left to go here in the second. 2-0 lead, but 2 minutes and 45 seconds of riding time for Zook. Zook's got that underhook. Like I said, if he can get him pushing forward, you know, Vogel's got headlocks from both sides. Obviously, like we were talking about the Greco stuff, but absolutely can hit it. But see, the thing is, they're playing smart. They're not really pushing in. They're hand fighting.
See, that deep underhook is risky against guys like Vogel. The trouble is how tall he is. Hard to get the right leverage
right.
For throws. And also, you don't want to come in straight on a shot without an angle because he's given up some size.
There, nice little throw by attempt.
We got some good movement here.
There it is again. They're taking top. That's not the dumbest idea in the world there. Van Clay right away, he says top. It's just a smart game plan. But this is what we talked about here in the second. We gotta create action right now, right off the bat. We can't allow that weight to get on us. Just get your hips out and away, like almost like a great quick Granby action.
This is where we want to be. He needs to just stay on his feet, do everything
good,
he can.
Good. Oh, that's locked hands. Yes, good call, Mike.
He didn't call that, I don't think.
Yes, he did.
He did.
Yes, he called it.
Oh, he did. Wow.
Yes,
wow.
Very good. And that's tough for the ref in that situation because he's on the opposite side of it. But very good call there. It's the right call. Minute 51 seconds here. The crowd's starting to get fired up. Right back to the tripod.
He
did it again.
To his feet is what he needs to do.
He locked again.
Don't want to go with his hands. He just needs to get to his feet. He needs to get his hands off the mat to his feet. Try to get another stall call or locked hands.
Yes, he got away. He needs to create angles, though.
It's a time match. Riding time is a factor. He absolutely needs a takedown.
Yeah, I have a feeling we're going to have a hard time riding him. I don't know. So takedown would be big. But, dude, it seems to me that we have the momentum here. But don't let him tie you up and slow you down.
Tied, so if he doesn't score, this will be over.
Yep, 100%. Riding time is locked up, 3 minutes and 11 seconds, so that is 1 point for Zook no matter what. Kind of tying us up here a little bit.
Not a lot of time to waste here. Last thing you want to do is wait here the last 10 seconds to create some action.
There it is again. He's trying to come back to it. So 45 seconds here. Come on, see if he can pull a rabbit out of a hat.
Get moving. Getting down to 30 seconds.
There it is again. Another one.
He needs to drop to the legs after that. Got to a leg. It's
circle,
gonna be
circle,
tough.
circle.
20 seconds.
Do it. Oh, no.
Oh, it's a tough spot to be.
Oh, man.
It's a lot of weight.
Stalemate it.
Got
10 seconds.
12 seconds.
Do it.
Need a stalemate here. If you let go of the legs, it's going to be tough to call now. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. That was a good attempt.
That was a hell of a fight for Vogel.
Yep.
Wrestling up at 285. I mean, giving up all that size. That turned out to be one hell of a match towards the end. He gave himself a chance to win that. And that's all you can really do. You know what I mean?
He
fought all the way through minute 7 in that situation.
And he gave up the original takedown, which cost him the match in the first 10 seconds of the first period, trying to throw with double overs.
Yep. So, you learn from that. Maybe a little bit more strategic next time, but hell of a match for Vogel. So, you know what? Tonight, Jimmy, it was good to get the guys back on the mat. Like I said, after an unfortunate cancellation where we were going to compete for the dual national championship last weekend, but these guys are ready to go here this weekend. Next weekend, we're fired up 35-6. Took it 8 out of 10 matches. What can I really say other than that? And when I say that they look a little bit worn down, it's kind of hard to believe when you win 8 out of 10 matches. Because Central's got a decent team, and they come to compete. They're ranked 12th in the country. It's one of those things where we'll just continue to get better. Like I said, this next month and a half, it's going to be with some really fun stuff going on. So, thanks again, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us tonight. Like I said, with my partner, Jimmy Davis, All-American. And I hope everybody has a safe and great night and weekend. And until next time, guys, take care.